Im dichten Fichtendickicht picken die flinken Finken tüchtig. Im dichten Fichtendickicht picken die flinken Finken tüchtig. I think here the challenge is, if you speak it faster, you want to say the tüchtig also as a tichtig, because you have all these I sounds before, the open I sound in German, and then you just want to continue doing what you already did, but it's an Ö, U umlaut there, so we have to watch out at the end of this sentence.
Exactly, well, and I find that this open U umlaut is a tougher one for people for some reason, because we don't want to make it open enough. We always want to make it sort of tüchtig, but It's actually not closed, it's open.
Yeah, that's right. And I also heard this American singers closing too much the umlauts in general. Ö, tüchtig, ö.
Much opener than, for example, the word like ach, ich fühl's.
Absolutely, yes.
The other sound that is problematic is the ch, the front ich laut.
That's true. Usually it is sang too way back in the throat, or more like a sch, like a sh. So what I usually use when I teach the ch is the English word you or year, the y letter at the beginning of the English word, like year. So when you speak the word year in English and you stay on the y without moving, blow the air through, then it's the same position of the tongue and the teeth like you would speak the word year. So when you say year and stop, then it's the same position like the ch.
Yeah, so basically you're stopping in the middle of a J glide, so you're on an E vowel. We do have this sound in English, actually, in the word huge.
Huge, yeah, that's perfect. And I would say you cannot be front enough for the CH.
I agree, because I find that a lot of Americans think that this sound should be somewhere up on the high part of your hard palate, and they try to say, eh.
Oh,
but that's so far back compared to where it should be.
Yeah, it's totally different. The CH is very behind the top teeth and the tip of the tongue is very forward.
Yeah, it's not sh. We're not saying sh.
No, totally not. It's a total different consonant.
The other thing is, you had talked about the open I vowel. The open I should also not be like middle of the mouth American, right?
No. No, it's one of the more front vowels, I, D, im Dichten. It's really behind your front teeth, very, very forward. Dichten, Fichten, Dickicht.
And I think in a word like Fichten, Dickicht, the hard thing is going back and forth from sh, k, sh, getting this, the K sound between the CH, the Ichlaut.
Mm-hmm. But you know, I think if you stay focused really on all the front vowels and consonants and just put it together without thinking of too much movement, it's actually easier. It's like Sprachökonomie, the economy of the language and the economy of moving your mouth around. The faster you speak, the less you actually move your throat and your lips and your jaw. So if you stay there relaxed but still small, then you can be much faster. Fichten. So the I is very much in front, the CH as well, and the T is very front. And the F as well, so it's actually very helpful. Fichten. Then you only put the K in and you go immediately in front again. Fichten, Dickicht.
Why don't we translate this?
How is it in English?
Okay, well, what, you say the words in German and I'll say them in English.
Im.
In the.
Dichten.
Thick.
Fichtendickicht.
Jungle of spruce trees.
Picken.
Peck.
Die.
The.
Flinken.
Nimble.
Finken.
Finches.
Tüchtig.
Heartily. So in the thick jungle of spruce trees, the nimble finches peck heartily.
Im dichten Fichtendickicht picken die flinken Finken tüchtig. Im dichten Fichtendickicht picken die flinken Finken tüchtig.